Up to this point, we've really worked a lot with creating motion tweens that involve movement. But you can also do property changes with motion tweens, meaning that not only are you able to move it from, let's say, left to right across the stage, but you can make it from small to big, from yellow to pink, and have it rotate all the way across the stage. Those are what we consider property changes. So let's see how to do this. We're going to start by creating our motion tween. So I'll click on my object and first convert it to a symbol. I want to create this as a movie clip. You can either do movie clip or graphic symbol. So here's MC star, and then go to insert motion tween, and it's going to have it last for 24 seconds or 24 frames, which is 1 second. So I'm going to go ahead and let's say 60 seconds. And now I want to move it from the top left to the bottom right. And there's my basic motion tween. So I can add a little bit of a curve by hovering over it. And there we go. So now we need to talk about property changes. Property changes are something other than movement. And the reason why we cover this is because a lot of people think motion tween means that you're animating only the motion or the movement, but you can also animate the appearance of it. So right now, with my playhead on frame one, I'll click on my star, and I want to change the width and height to something, let's say 22. And because I set it at frame 60 at a certain size, oh no, it didn't stay that way. So now I can click on that symbol on frame 60, and I can make it bigger. And perhaps go right there. All right, so we should see it grow from small to large. So what else can we manipulate? Well, let's go ahead and do rotation. So let's say we want it to rotate. Let's say by the 60th frame, we want it to rotate a couple of times. Oh, you have to click on the motion tween first. Okay, I want it to rotate, let's say 10 times. So let's see how that looks. There we go. So not only have we animated motion, now we've animated size and we've animated rotation. So let's go ahead and try to animate the color. So I'll click on that star, and because it's a movie clip symbol, I can now mess with color effects. So from here, I'm going to go to style and choose, let's say, tint. And right now, I'm going to leave it the way it is. It has a red tint, and the tint is zero because I just want it to be red. And I want to say by this time, I want it to be blue. So I'll click on my symbol, and I'll choose kind of a bright blue. And how much of a tint do we want it to have? That looks good to me. So it's going to transform from yellow all the way to blue. So we can even change all the colors, let's say every 15 frames. So I'll click on the 15th, or I'll move my playhead to the 15th frame and click on the symbol. And this one I want to have, let's say, a pink tint, and it's going to be heavy. And then by the 30th frame, let's say I want this to be, let's say, a green tint. And by 45, say I want this to be an orange tint. And then by 60. So now we've got yellow to pink to green to orange to blue. So there we've changed the appearance. And last but not least, we can grab the symbol and we can do a filter. So let's go ahead and add a new one, and we'll do a glow. So right now the glow, let's go ahead and make it a white glow. And you can kind of see it a little bit, but let's say by the 15th frame, you have to click on that symbol again. I want the glow to be, let's say, a lot further out. And let's say I want it to be green. And let's do high quality. So you can bump up the strength, or you can make it bigger, smaller, and this is the tint that's happening right now. So then by here, it's still glowing. So let's go ahead and make that glow 0, so it kind of looks like it's pulsing. And then here, maybe we want the glow to come back to 100. And then out here, we want it to be 0. Okay, so those are animating property changes. So now as it moves through, it's going to have glow, and it's going to change color, and it's rotating, and it has a motion, and it gets bigger. So let's see this in action. So the rotation is a little bit weird just because the star is not perfectly centered around its anchor point. But otherwise, we did a lot of good property changes just in one motion tween.